Malignant hyperthermia is a life-threatening emergency caused by a drug reaction to inhaled anesthetics in patients that are genetically susceptible. It presents with the classic triad of RAT symptoms, which stands for skeletal muscle rigidity, acidosis, and a really high temperature. Now, the actual pathogenesis of this disease is rooted in a genetic predisposition, usually due to a range of autosomal dominant mutations in the RYR1 gene. This causes abnormalities in the receptors of skeletal muscles, which allow excessive calcium accumulation in the presence of certain anesthetic triggering agents. This leads to a hypermetabolic state with sustained contraction and muscle breakdown, also known as rhabdomyolysis. Now let's move on to the actual clinical features of malignant hyperthermia. The initial onset may occur soon after induction with general anesthetic. The most reliable clinical signs heralding this syndrome are unexplained high end-tidal carbon dioxide and tachypnea. Consequently, a patient might develop the classic RAT symptoms. Rigidity is generalized, and in the presence of neuromuscular blockade, it's considered pathognomonic of this disease. Associated rhabdomyolysis from contractions can induce hyperkalemia as well. Acidosis will develop in most patients and is usually a mixed metabolic and respiratory acidosis. A high temperature is usually a later sign, with the mean temperature being about 39.1 degrees. Some key differentials that mimic this condition are the CATs, catecholamine tumor or a pheochromocytoma, A for acute porphyria crisis, T for thyrotoxicosis, and S for sepsis. Moving on to its management, the mainstay of treatment for malignant hyperthermia can be easily remembered with the SHADE acronym. This stands for stopping and discontinuing the inhaled agent, achieving heat control by cooling the patient down, potentially with cold IV fluids, using activated charcoal filters to remove residual agents from the anesthetic workstation, giving the patient D for dantrolene, which is a muscle relaxant used as an antidote. Finally, consider checking and optimizing a patient's electrolytes, as hyperkalemia can be fatal. Let's summarize all of this by reviewing our mnemonics together. Malignant hyperthermia has RAT features like rigidity, acidosis, and a temperature, which means you should always consider CATs as differentials, like excessive catecholamines from a pheochromocytoma, acute porphyria crisis, thyrotoxicosis, and sepsis. It literally has hyperthermia in the name, so you should manage it with SHADE, including stopping the agent, achieving heat control, using activated charcoal filters, giving dantrolene, and optimizing electrolytes. Acronyms can be the best way to get through med school, so check out this playlist. All my videos have catchy mnemonics to remember content. Thanks for watching Townsend Teachings.